On October 13, 1973, Sister Agnes received a message from Our Lady. She said, "If men do not repent and better themselves, the Father will inflict a terrible punishment on all humanity. It will be a punishment greater than the deluge, the great flood, such as one will never have seen before. Fire will fall from the sky and will wipe out a great part of humanity, the good as well as the bad, sparing neither priests nor faithful. The survivors will find themselves so desolate that they will envy the dead. The only alms which will remain for you will be the rosary and the sign left by my son. Each day recite the prayers of the rosary. With the rosary, pray for the Pope, the bishops and the priests. On May 1, 1976, the first Saturday of the month, an angel told Sister Agnes, "Attach great importance to this day for the glory of God and of His Holy Mother. With courage spread this devotion, the Fatima First Saturday devotion, among the greatest number." On December 10, 1925, in Pontevedra, Spain, Our Lady of Fatima appeared to the visionary Sister Lucia. She requested the practice of the First Saturday devotion that consists of doing the following with the intention of making reparation for the offenses to her Immaculate Heart: receive the sacrament of confession within 8 days before or after the first Saturday of each month, and on that day receive the Eucharist, pray 5 decades of the Rosary, and keep Our Lady company for 15 minutes while meditating on the mysteries of the Rosary. 46 years later, on October 6, 2019, at 3:30 a.m., Sister Agnes received a new warning message at Akita from an angel. The message was similar to the Prophet Jonah's message of warning to the idol-worshipping Ninevites to repent or be destroyed. Jonah's message was, 40 more days and Nineveh will be overthrown. The Ninevites believed God. A fast was proclaimed, and all of them, from the greatest to the least, put on sackcloth. When the king of Nineveh heard about the message, he got up from his throne, removed his robe, covered himself with sackcloth, and sat in ashes. When God saw what they did and how they turned from their evil ways, He relented and did not bring on them the destruction He had threatened. May we imitate the good example of the pagan Ninevites who worshipped idols. Sister Agnes received the new warning message on October 6, 2019. This is the first public message that Sister Agnes has received in the last 48 years. She is now 90 years old. Signs and wonders accompanied Sister Agnes' original message, including the weeping of her statue of Our Lady of Akita 101 times. Scientific examination proved that they were human tears. This is the message that Sister Agnes received on October 6, 2019, "Cover yourself in ashes and please pray the Penitential Rosary every day. You, Sister Agnes, become like a child and every day please make sacrifices." The warning was short and to the point, as was the warning to the Ninevites. May we respond to it now as they did. A penitential rosary is a rosary that is prayed with contrition and in sorrow for one's own sins or the sins of others and for their conversion. It is offered in atonement and reparation to our merciful God, who is so horribly offended by the sins of the modern world. Let us fervently pray the rosary daily for the conversion of all people who are lost in sin and have not come to know the love of the one true God. Thank you for supporting my channel. Please like and subscribe. May God bless you and keep you. Our Lady, Queen of Peace, pray for us. Rosary. With the rosary, pray for the Pope, the bishops and the priests. On May 1, 1976, the first Saturday of the month, an angel told Sister Agnes, "Attach great importance to this day for the glory of God and of His Holy Mother. With courage spread this devotion, the Fatima First Saturday devotion, among the greatest number." On December 10, 1925, in Pontevedra, Spain, Our Lady of Fatima appeared to the visionary Sister Lucia. She requested the practice of the First Saturday devotion that consists of doing the following with the intention of making reparation for the offenses to her Immaculate Heart: receive the sacrament of confession within 8 days before or after the first Saturday of each month, and on that day receive the Eucharist, pray 5 decades of the Rosary, and keep Our Lady company for 15 minutes while meditating on the mysteries of the Rosary. 46 years later, on October 6, 2019, at 3:30 a.m., Sister Agnes received a new warning message at Akita from an angel. The message was similar to the prophet Jonah's message of warning to the idol-worshipping Ninevites to repent or be destroyed. Jonah's message was, 40 more days and Nineveh will be overthrown. The Ninevites believed God. A fast was proclaimed, and all of them, from the greatest to the least, put on sackcloth. When the king of Nineveh heard about the message, he got up from his throne, removed his robe, covered himself with sackcloth, and sat in ashes. When God saw what they did and how they turned from their evil ways, he relented and did not bring on them the destruction he had threatened. May we imitate the good example of the pagan Ninevites who worshipped idols. Sister Agnes received the new warning message on October 6, 2019. This is the first public message that Sister Agnes has received in the last 48 years. She is now 90 years old. Signs and wonders accompanied Sister Agnes' original message, including the weeping of her statue of Our Lady of Akita 101 times. Scientific examination proved that they were human tears. This is the message that Sister Agnes received on October 6, 2019, cover yourself in ashes and please pray the Penitential Rosary every day. You, Sister Agnes, become like a child and every day please make sacrifices. The warning was short and to the point, as was the warning to the Ninevites. May we respond to it now as they did. A penitential rosary is a rosary that is prayed with contrition and in sorrow for one's own sins or the sins of others and for their conversion. It is offered in atonement and reparation to our merciful God who is so horribly offended by the sins of the modern world. Let us fervently pray the rosary daily for the conversion of all people who are lost in sin and have not come to know the love of the one true God. Thank you for supporting my channel. Please like and subscribe. May God bless you and keep you. Our Lady, Queen of Peace, pray for us.